What a nice, agreeable male you are, Smith. Come closer. Let me see your teeth. Open your mouth. Wider. Say ah.
Ah.
Very healthy. Stand up. Throw out your chest. Out. Out, I said out.
It's out as far as it'll go.
All right. Bend your elbow and clench your fists. What a pitiful specimen you are, Smith. But you'll do. For a while. You will do.
As what, noble Niolani?
As my consort. What else? And how is the work coming, Smith?
Under my artistic guidance, it's almost complete, noble Niolani.
What a nice, comfortable consort you are.
He's in there. We've done the work you expected of us. We've cleared the pad and erected the arch.
Good.
Under my strict supervision, of course.
But there are other planets.
And what's that supposed to mean?
Colonization is a never-ending task for my nation. You'll be needed to prepare for their arrival wherever they land.
Are you saying you intend to hold us captives indefinitely?
No, not indefinitely. Just as long as your physical stamina lasts. After which, you will be like them.
Oh.
You are inviting death.
Well, it's better than being one of your male slaves.
I could quite easily have destroyed him. But he is powerful enough to be useful. He'll recover. Ah, the colonists arrive with the light of the sun. I will introduce you to them as my consort, as they come through the arch. I hope they like your arch, Smith.
Oh, they'll love it, noble Niolani. They will simply love it. Now tell me, dear lady, where do you and I go after the arrival of the colonists?
To seek another habitable planet, of course.
I know an excellent planet. It happens to be in a neighboring solar system. It's called Earth. I would simply adore to show you around.
Males never show females around, Smith. You go where I go, and never vice versa.
Of course, dear lady. Never vice versa. Go.